What are some of the things that you expect to see in the YTV broadcast that you're about to watch? Tell me some things that you think you're going to see. Let's make some predictions.
YTV News is a weekly half-hour news magazine program for young Canadians. We report on national and international news and take an in-depth look at important issues. We also feature consumer and lifestyle stories that are relevant to teens.
YTV Outreach helps you use YTV News and certain other YTV programs in the classroom. This reel you're watching and all YTV News programs are completely copyright cleared for classroom use. YTV Outreach has several lesson plans, studying the issues and the way the media looks at them.
As young people today, we are active participants in politics, culture, and society. We have a positive contribution to make.
You can interact with us by studying the show, sending us DIYs, and giving us your feedback on YTV News.
Hi, I'm Michael Quast. I'm the producer of YTV News. Well, one of them anyways. There's another one, Jeff Prera from CTV, and together we work with a whole team to bring you each week YTV News.
8, 7, 6, 5 to red, 4, 3, 2,
red.
1.
Red online.
To YTV News.
It's been a week filled with, well, news.
And trivia. I read this week that Australian researchers have found women's voices are deeper now than they were 50 years ago,
mostly because of our changing roles in society.
That's right. Researchers say that more women are occupying positions of power, and that like everyone else, they associate lower-pitched voices with maturity and authority.
We move now to the week's news. The struggle to change South African society has again grabbed the attention of the world.
Take.
CTV is news. I mean, that's what they do best. And they have bureaus all over the world. They get feeds from ABC and NBC. And through CTV, we have access to those stories.
It's 3012H for ABC News 1.
Of course, YTV provides, you know, the image, the content, the editorial view, the slant on the show. And CTV sort of provides the nuts and bolts.
It's been quite an experience for me to work in the CTV environment. It's the big leagues, basically. And I'm learning a lot of things from a lot of people that that are respected in the industry.
First, they get their idea. It goes through a process where people agree or disagree. In other words, they have to fight for that idea. If they fight for the idea hard enough and we agree that it's an idea worth doing, they have to do all kinds of research, make sure that they have their contacts set up, know where they're going, why they're going there.
Hi, Diana. It's Rhonda McMichael calling from YTV News.
Sometimes people think of just the storyline and not the visuals that you need to incorporate into a story. And since this is TV and not radio, that's an important element.
But here's some advice. The next time you see an alien spaceship coming your way, grab the camcorder.
After the research is done, then you set up the crews. You make sure that, you know, you have your camera and audio people on board. If you need any special effects or you need any special equipment, that you have that, then you go out, you shoot the story. You come back, you do a shot log, you make sure that everything is there, that you need it to be there, and then you edit it.
The track, the rest of the track, finding the right dress, finding the right date.
You voice it.
3, 2, 1. The best night takes planning and plenty of it.
Okay.
Many times after a piece is done from a field producer, Jeff or I will look at it and, you know, we'll say, well, that's good, but change this part, this doesn't work.
Hi, Mike, it's Jeff.
Hi, Jeff, how you doing? Not too bad. This is the other producer on the phone.
I got a lineup that we were talking about earlier. I got it in here.
Jeff and I and our associate producer, Romano, do all the news copy stories, and we also write all the links for the show. And that whole process takes about 2 days, too, to write the show.
for the actual taping, we have a script meeting on the Friday night and go through the lines and go through the news and understand the news stories and then show up really early and on taping day and then tape the actual show.
In terms of performance, it's a hard job to be on in front of the camera, and a lot of people don't understand that.
Well, the federal government has slapped a new tax on bikes and bike parts made outside Canada. The tax
actually the biggest challenge, at least for me personally, I wouldn't say for the show, but the biggest challenge is just to make sure that I'm never stagnant, that I'm always growing in one area, either within my writing skills, my on-air skills, or my journalism skills, just to make sure that there's always something keeping me abreast.
The sets drop down from the ceiling, they're stored in the ceiling, they're dropped down. We have lighting people and grip people setting everything up, making sure the shots are right. We have our assistant director timing the show, making sure that the show will come out at the right time and making sure that all the elements are there. The job of the director is to make sure that the shots are right, that everyone is on board where they're supposed to be.
Yeah, the tape was fine, it was just short.
She provides artistic input as well, and many times it's, you know, save the day with ideas. Our jobs as producers is to make sure that the quality of the show or the feel of the show is what we have in mind.
Stand by to roll green in 3.
And variably a mistake will happen. It's not always talent. It's, you know, sometimes the machine broke or, you know, the light went out and we have to do it again.
Okay, Marrett, so pick it up, slow it down, and don't pause.
Of course, the bottom line all the way through it is we have to be out of there by 11:45. And that's probably our biggest job, to make sure that we come, you know, we finish the show on time.
They also create logic within their music, whatever that means.
I think the biggest reward is, and I think I can speak for everybody on this, is that the show is getting better and better as we go along. Each show that we do improves this much more, and it is rewarding to see that.
That was by far the best show we've done yet.
Yay!
I think the biggest thing is just, you know, you're relieved that it's done, you're glad that it's done, you feel good about it, and then ultimately you wait for the numbers. You want to see how many people are watching the show, because that really decides whether or not the show is doing well or not. If you have people watching the show, you're okay.
I think it was our synchronized news anchoring.
Yes, I'd like to know where that happened.
Okay, are we ready, Mary?
You got it.
Hey, you, I know you, I know you, dig a hole, dig a hole.
I certainly think that good fortune has something to do with it, but in order to continue to get opportunities presented to you, it's a matter of working very hard. And it sometimes takes a toll on you, and you do make a lot of sacrifices. And I think that anyone who is, you know, wanting to get into that type of thing has to be prepared to make sacrifices. But I think it's a matter of loving it too.
We try not to pander to the audience, we try not to talk down to them, but we try to give them some information that they can walk away with and understand what's going on.
Not that we think that we can change the world with YTV News, but we certainly want to make youth know that they can make a difference.
This show is for Canadian teenagers, and if they have ideas, we want to hear about them.
I want you to write in those columns what you think are the strengths and the weaknesses of those speakers, because I want you to decide for yourself which of those speakers is doing a better job of convincing you. Right?
It's your turn to make the news by expressing your views.
Do it by videotaping a one-minute editorial on VHS or YTV News.
Talk about whatever's important to you.
Start by recording your name, where you're from, and the name of your school.
Just follow these guidelines.
Look right into camera and speak clearly.
Speak loudly. Keep your language clean.
No smoking, eating, drinking, or chewing gum.
Oh yeah, don't stand in front of a bright light. Whoa, make sure you hit the right button.
Then send your tape to YTV News, 64 Jefferson Avenue, Unit 18, Toronto, Ontario, M6K 3H3.
We like getting views from all over the country, and we want to keep the momentum going. That's why we decided to put together a how-to video. We've called it DIY the movie.
Witness the birth of an idea. An idea worth sharing with the rest of the world. So take a camera and record it. A video camera. This is television. Now that's okay. Don't worry about it. Great. Now if you need help, ask someone. Don't be shy. When you shoot your item, there are a few things you need to remember. Don't worry, they're easy. First, okay. First, make sure the camera's on. Good. Now, as you can see, not, the subject should be close to the camera. I said close, not attached to it. Back up a bit. Bit more. Perfect. You now have what is called headroom. Important because most people move their head when they talk. Please, no smoking. Or drinking. No swearing. Remember to speak clearly. Clearly, not loudly. Oh yeah, we also need to know your name. In fact, why not spell it for us?
B-O-C-B.
Hi, Bob. Bob, you can't stand there. Or there. You see how bright the sky is behind you, Bob? Yeah, well, it turns you into a shadow. Great. Now, when you're done, rush it off to the post office. They'll rush it off to us, and if you did as we asked, we'll put it on the air.
Why is Grey Poupon mustard not gray? It's yellow.
And in return, you get a nifty baseball hat.
Five weeks in Port Hardy. It's like a cold summer vacation and almost as long. I'm Zane Primer and I was a student at Port Hardy Secondary School until our teachers went out on a full-scale strike at the beginning of April. It's like a dream come true, I guess. Unless, of course, you're in grade 12 and actually want to do the graduation thing. Our district offered its students $300 a month to go to school somewhere else. Well, the trouble is, the nearest school district is over 3 hours away, and Victoria is 7. Moving out isn't exactly what I had planned, even with a whopping $300. Our district has been out for 5 weeks, and other districts have had similar experiences. CBC and Czech TV are covering this like it's some back page news ad, and the province has the Minister of Labor, Mo Sahota, studying this. Minister of Labor? Hello? Teachers? Students? School? It sounds like education to me. And people wonder why our education's in trouble.
In Canada, the Constitution says that everyone should have freedom of expression. Does that mean then we expose our children and all the people of Canada to people that are voicing their opinions of hate, anger, violence? For example, should white supremacist groups be able to go out in the streets and demonstrate in front of everyone how they feel about people based on their religion, their class, their beliefs, their color? Should, like, teachers be able to say that the Holocaust didn't exist if that's their belief? My main question is, where do we draw the line between discrimination and freedom of expression?
I'm here today to talk about graduated licenses. There's good and there's bad involved in this new legislation. The first thing is, because I guess it's helping us as youth in a way, because it's going to bring down the insurance costs. And we all know how prohibitive they are now. I can't afford my own car. As well, it's going to cut down on the deaths and the fatalities and injuries that are caused mostly by our age group, unfortunately. So in a way, it's helping us. But on the other side of the coin, the government's effectively ruining our young adulthood by imposing this legislation. They say you have to have an older person in the car or someone has their license. Just imagine, you go to a movie, you want to go somewhere else afterwards, and you lean over to kiss your girlfriend and your father's in your way. I mean, who wants that? And as well, they want us to have this big L in the back of the car so they know you're a learner driver. But to me, somebody's going to see that big L in the back and just think it says loser. So I don't know, there's two sides to the story, and if it helps save lives, that's the best thing they can do.
Today I'd like to talk about life being a twin. See, I'm a twin, this guy right here, he's my brother. Don't we look alike? Well, life being a twin is extremely hard because he's always doing bad stuff, while I'm a perfect little angel, and I get to blame for it. So people know me as the scapegoat for him. Just look at him, look at that devilish face. So, life being a twin is extremely hard, but it has its good points and bad points. Good points are, if a girl likes him and I look better than him, then she'll prefer me over him. Except when she's ugly, which is the most girls that he gets. But the bad points about being a twin is you have to split your allowance. I only get $5 a week.
To empower, excite, entertain, challenge, and inform.
It only takes one person to make a difference. One person who knows what's going on. You.
But how do you know what is important if you don't know the issues?
It's time to take ownership of the news.
And it's about more than just news.
Face the facts. Break down the walls.
Because it's our world and our future.